I've had this small impact wrench for almost a year now, and so far I've liked it a lot. This is basically the same tool as one sold on Banggood or AliExpress, but with different battery and I believe much better quality control. I haven't had any problems with this until now. The battery ran empty the other day and for some reason it wouldn't charge anymore. This battery is essentially a paperweight now. The specs are 20 volts, which in case of lithium tool batteries is same as 18 volts, and 3 amp hours. Based on those numbers and size of this battery, there are probably 2 cells in parallel and 5 in series. This battery is useless in its current shape, and I decided to open it to see if it could be revived. While doing so, I decided to document this process for warranty claim purposes. Power tool batteries are often easy to take apart and put together. In this case, there are 4 Phillips screws in the corners. Just as easy as it should be. Yep, 2 cells in parallel and 5 in series, just as I thought. Here are the markings on the cells. This battery seems to have a battery management system which most likely monitors cell voltages and possibly does some balancing. Let's see. The brains of this board is programmable microcontroller, which is basically a black box when reverse engineering circuits. The microcontroller is made by Above, which I've seen in other power tool batteries multiple times before. And these 3 large components are MOSFETs, which are connected in parallel and can disconnect the negative end of the cells from this PCB. There doesn't seem to be anything that is visibly broken, so it's time to take out the multimeter and start measuring the cells. Full cell should have voltage of 4.2 volts, and empty can have anything from 3.5 to little less than 3 volts. The first cell reads 0 volts. Let's measure again from another spot. And still 0. Okay, that cell is totally dead. How about the other cells? Second one reads 3.5 volts, that's perfectly fine, and the rest of the cells have pretty similar readings as well. For some reason that first cell is completely dead, while others are fine. It may have been coincidence that it's the first cell that has died, or there might be reason for it in the PCB. It's a shame that fault on one pair of cells ruins the whole battery, but that's the way it is. I'll desolder this PCB and I'll take a closer look. I'll be right back. The board is out and I have a basic idea of its design. I wanted to find out if this protection board could actually be draining the first cell by being powered from that one cell alone. Fortunately, or unfortunately, I didn't find such design flaw. The first cell is only connected to one place, and that is the high resistance voltage divider used while measuring the cell voltage. The total resistance is about 100 kilo ohms, and there's no other path from first cell positive end to the ground. And that shouldn't cause this problem, especially considering there are similar voltage dividers on other cells, and they haven't discharged unevenly. There are MOSFETs in line with the voltage dividers, those can fully disable the small current draw of resistive voltage dividers. The 6th SOT23 component is PNP transistor, which controls the current flow coming from the 5th cell to this circuit. So, just to repeat myself, the voltage of first cell is only being monitored. It's not powering this whole circuit. And this set of MOSFETs is not balancing this battery pack unlike I initially thought. Even though I didn't do a full reverse engineering of this circuit, I have a decent idea what each section does. I tried to divide the board in few distinctive sections and I've added captions to each of them. I would say it's a decent design and this board didn't directly cause the death of the first cell. Considering I have taken good care of this tool, charge the battery when I've noticed the charge level to be low and so on, I'd say this fault was just an unfortunate, unavoidable thing. Now I just hope I'll get a new battery due to this first one being defective during the warranty period.